Wassup guys, Baker here. Today I am back with another tutorial. This will be the retro audio visualizer sort of thing. So basically it's something kind of like this, kind of messing around. Let's do a quick preview here. So if you're a music channel and you want to do a cool retro visualizer type of thing, this tutorial is for you. And you don't have to have a circle design like this. You can have normal kind of retro, like a stereo looking thing. So yeah, just want to show you guys a quick preview of what we're doing. Let's go ahead and delete all these compositions and start over. Alright, let's make a new composition, 720p, 10 minutes long, just default, whatever. And okay, let's actually go back and rename this to main. So main comp. Let's make another new composition. Let's call this song. And while we're here, let's drop in our song into this. Okay. Make another new comp. Let's call this color. And one more new comp. Call this background. So I guess we can start with background since we're here. Make a new solid. Okay. Ramp, and let's make this a radio ramp, bring this to the middle, make this black, make this a dark gray, and bring this down so we get a nice vignette circle ramp thing. Alright, let's go to main again. Let's make a new solid, and let's call this bars. Alright. And search up some audio spectrum. Drag that on. And let's also bring out our song composition. Okay. So we can link our audio spectrum layer to the song. Alright, so we should be able to see some frequencies here. Start point, let's bring this to 0 all the way to the left, and then 720 all the way down. And then 1280 all the way to the right, 720 all the way down. All right, let's see, let's bring the frequency down to maybe, let's say, 800. So it's a little bit more smooth. Okay, let's bring the maximum height up so we can see more detail. And don't worry about it going off the page or the composition. That seems about, that's okay, maybe 6,000. Okay, I want to see some detail out here, so that's good. A lot of people have asked me that they told me that their audio spectrum is really fast and choppy, and they want to smooth it out a little bit, so let's see. You can see it's wiggling pretty fast, and we want it to be a little bit smoother, so we can increase the audio duration over here. It's at 90 right now. Let's set this to maybe 200, 250-ish. See what that looks like. Should smooth out the bars a little bit. So yeah, let's do 250. Now the thing is with this is the longer you have your audio duration, the earlier it ends up being. So it's actually not aligned with the song anymore. It's kind of offset, so we need to fix that. So watch the bass. It doesn't really line up. So if we have audio duration at 250, the offset needs to be negative 250. So do one more RAM preview just to show you that fix. Everything should be lined up again. Alright, let's see. Alright, looks a lot better. Let's increase the thickness a little bit and maybe the frequency bands just a little bit so we get a little bit more detail. We are going to add mosaic. This is the main kind of blocky effect. Now our composition is widescreen, 16 by 9. So we need horizontal to be 16, vertical to be 9. So we get perfect squares. Now they're not all the same color, so we'll search up some levels, and we'll go to the alpha channel, and bring the alpha white, input white down. So crushes that, duplicate it to clean up everything else. So we just get these clean, nice bars here. All right, so let's go to color because we want this to be colorized. So go to your color composition, make a new solid, comp size, any color is fine because we're gonna add a fill. Let's make this green and kind of click in the corner about here. Looks good. Let's duplicate. Make the solid setting. Let's change this to 160. And let's change this to a kind of golden yellow orange, almost like that. And let's also duplicate one more time. We'll make this red. But let's change it to 80 instead of 60, so we have a thin bar. So let's move the red bar all the way to the top, about here, which should be 40 for the Y position. And the yellow, let's also move this up to the top, that should be 160 for the Y position. Alright, that looks good. Let's go back to main. Let's bring out color and put it underneath our bars, and let's set this to alpha matte. So now our bars are colorized. Now I kind of don't like the continuous blocky look. Real pixels on a stereo or whatever are kind of separated. So we're going to make a new solid. Call this grid. Make it comp size. Okay. Search up grid. And generate grid. Drag that on. We're going to make this width and height sliders, and let's set the anchor to the bottom left corner, so 0 and 720, and let's make the width 80 by 80. So that's what the mosaic, the 16 by 9, made it into 80 by 80 blocks. We'll set the transfer mode of the grid to silhouette alpha. So what that does is it kind of makes a cutout without adding anything. So just cut out right there. We can make the border 10 if you want. Alright, so now we get that cool blocky retro feel. So you can actually leave it like this if you're gonna add this to maybe like a 3D stereo or something, kinda cool effect or whatever, but a lot of music channels have a sort of ring. So we're gonna take the grid, bars, and color. Take all of these and precompose. Actually, you need to precompose all of it. Because the song, remember the bars are linked to the song. So let's precompose all of that. You can call this retro bars. Alright, so the trick for the ring is to use polar coordinates. And we change this to rectangle to polar. And boom. Except it's kind of, you know, inside out, backwards. So what do we do? Well, let's search up transform before the polar coordinates. Uncheck uniform scale, and the scale height will be -100. So it'll be facing the right way. But now it's all the way in the center. So what we need to do is actually change the scale height to -50 and scoot down the position halfway, so this would be 540. So now we get a ring, but it's still pretty stretched out, and you can go for that look, that's okay, but I want to fix that. One more thing is it's not symmetrical, which is optional, but I like to have it symmetrical, so we can search up motion tile after transform, and the tile width 50. And mirror edges. Close this off. Pull the coordinates back on. And symmetrical. Pretty nice. Let's rotate this layer 90. So it's upright. So that looks pretty cool. It's still a little bit wide. So we can go back to the retro bars. Go to the grid. Make the width 40. And the bars, let's change the mosaic horizontal blocks. Let's double that to 32. Alright, so back to main. Now our blocks are pretty close to squares, which looks pretty cool. I think that's pretty much it. Oh, don't forget your background layer. Right, so you can swap out this ramp with any graphic or background that you want. A picture of a beach or some cool pictures, you know. Get in the background, it's an easy way to swap it out. But there's your audio bars. Let's see, another idea I had is, let's say our background had a kind of white theme, it was bright. So let's change our colors, let's change the green to, let's say, like black. And let's turn off the yellow layer. So we just get two colors. That looks pretty cool. One thing we can do is take a hue and saturation on the retro bars. And let's keyframe the channel range. Let's start it at like negative 80 rotations. Go to the end of the comp, make it positive 80 rotations. So the red kind of changes into different colors. Kind of cool rainbow effect blinking. We're going a little fast, so it should be at a nice speed. But anyways, the whole idea is getting this blocky audio spectrum effect. I think it looks pretty nifty. If you guys make any cool ideas or music videos or whatever you want, go ahead and post a link in the description, or in the comments. Let me know if you have any questions. Hit me up on Facebook and Twitter. Like and favorite, all that cool stuff. And I'll try to maybe make a project file and give you a free download, some ideas I got and stuff. So, yeah, if you want that, let me know. Leave a like and stuff. And, yeah, alright, peace.